Hello and welcome to this presentation on Microsoft Project. During this presentation, we're going to be looking at what is new in Microsoft Project Professional 2013. This is a picture of me. My name is Tom Henry. I'm a consultant here at EPMA. And you're in the right place. Thanks for watching. I'm now going to demonstrate the task path highlighting feature, which is new to Microsoft Project 2013. So I've got a schedule here, I've got a summary task, some tasks here, a milestone, and I've also got some hierarchy going on within my tasks. So as you can see, I've got some predecessors populated already. Now what I want to do, for milestone one, I want to see which tasks are predecessors. So the new feature will allow me to click on milestone one. I'm then going to go to the format ribbon. In the bar style section of the format ribbon, we'll find the task path highlighting feature. I'm going to click on that. I get four options: predecessors, driving predecessors, successors, and driven successors. Now what I want to look at is the predecessors. So I'm going to click on predecessors. And now I can see task 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 are predecessors to milestone 1. And that makes sense. Now if I click on task 3, I can see that task 2 is a predecessor. However, task 1 is not. So that's right. What about if I click on task 4? Now I can see that task 1, 2, and 3 are predecessors. Now whilst on task 4, I want to know which ones are driving this task. So if the duration of that task increased, would push out this task that I'm currently clicked on. So that would be a driving predecessor. So I'm going to click on task 4. Click on the task path, and I'm going to turn on the driving predecessors. With that selected, I can now see in dark orange which ones are driving. And if I'm not sure what the colors represent, I can hover over the task, and I'll get the tooltip. Path driving predecessor. If I go in the other one, hover over this one, path predecessor, so it's not driving. So that's the driven and non-driven predecessors. I'm now going to demonstrate the successor and driven successor task path highlighting. So from task 1, I want to see which tasks are successor tasks to task 1. So from the format ribbon, in the bar style section of the format ribbon, we have the task path highlighting. I'm going to select that. And I'm going to select successors. Now I can see, right where on the Gantt chart, we have these purple tasks. Path successor, and that means that task 4 and task 5 are successor tasks to task 1. If I click on task 2, the highlighting will be updated, and I can see which tasks are the successor tasks to task 2. In this case, it's 3, 4, and 5. Now, perhaps I want to see which tasks are driven successors. By driven successors, I mean, should the end date of this task that I selected be increased, we would therefore push out the start date of the next successor task. So I'm going to turn on the driven successor highlighting. I can see the Gantt chart's updated. Now I've got the purple ones, which means driven successors. So for task 2, should that duration be increased, it will push out these three tasks, start date. On task 1, it wouldn't actually push out these three because they're driven by task 2, and there's actually some slack in task 1. I actually see the slack by using the slack checkbox in the bar style section of the format ribbon as well, so I can see that it's that slack, therefore they are not driven successors. So that's the end of this demonstration. If you'd like to find out more, please feel free to visit our website. It's epmainc.com. We've actually got a blog where you can find out lots more information about these things and further on what we've actually just covered. That's epmablog.com. Feel free to send me an email with your feedback on this video, or if there's any suggestions for future videos, I'll be very welcome to hear that. tom.henry@epmainc.com. I'm on Twitter. Follow me, tomhenryepm. So here's what's next. Download Microsoft Project, start playing with it. It's a great tool. Visit our blog. Look at my Twitter, learn more at Microsoft.com, And obviously, talk to us about Microsoft Project 2013 training. We have the largest dedicated EPM training center in the US.